Hi, welcome to Free Academic English. I'm Geraldine, and today we're going to talk about the speaking part of the TOEFL and IELTS and how to improve your score. How to really improve your score. The question is it possible to dramatically increase your score with a few tricks in a short time? Well, it depends. The answer is yes, if you just took the TOEFL or the IELTS without knowing what the exam was about. And then you got a low score, lower than your real level. So with a few tricks and tips, just getting to know the exam you're taking, yes, your score can dramatically increase. Only in that case, which is not most of the cases. The usual case is that you prepared for the exam, you took the exam, and you got a score. And the score sort of represents your real level. How to increase it dramatically with effort and study. It'll take a little time. That all depends on how much time you invest on studying English. This video is about my experience, my students' experience. So usually people take, or students I've seen, take the exam when they need a high score, underscore, and their level is not yet there. But they know that in order to get a higher score, they need to use like very fancy vocabulary or really new words, but they force it. And what happens when you force something? You know, either TOEFL or IELTS, they both evaluate your vocabulary, the grammar you use, the pronunciation, the flow of your speech, and the basic reasoning behind your argument. Just staying in topic. So what happens if you have a normal, a good grammar, good vocabulary, and good pronunciation and good flow, but you think that you want to use this word that you should use because it's advanced academic English, and you put it there into what you're saying, and you end up with a lower score because you didn't know the word that well, so probably you used it incorrectly. You didn't know it well, so probably you used bad grammar with it. You didn't know it well, so you had to think about it, and that made like a cut into your flow of speech. So you wanted to increase your score, but you ended up lowering it. What to do then? First thing, let's be aware that these are academic exams. So they expect you to use formal English, academic English. So the more formal language you use, the better. I'm not saying old, archaic, never used. I'm just saying formal and academic. So we want to avoid slang. We want to avoid phrasal verbs when there are more specific verbs that can tell the same thing. But the trick is to do that naturally. Because you know you have to do that, but you're thinking too much about it. As I was too when I took the IELTS. So the more natural, the better. Do you want to naturally speak like that in a formal way in an academic environment, which will be university? You will have to address your professors or fellow classmates, people you may not know at first. So you are formal in those situations. So how to get used to this academic English? By entering into the academic world. There's no better way than that. Maybe there is, but this one is good too. So let's enter into this more formal academic world, because the English you are surrounded by is the English you are going to end up copying, repeating, say naturally. If you're in contact with it enough, you'll find yourself using it naturally. Of course, you were present if you were surrounded by it actively, if you were listening to something actively. If, for example, you're learning with songs and you are a fan of, I don't know, hip hop, that's good for your English in general. But for this kind of English, not so much, because they will use a very, very informal language that you won't be able to use in a speaking for IELTS or TOEFL. Or for example, Bruno Mars, You know, I love Bruno Mars. I love his music, his songs. They're great. And not formal English at all. I mean, he uses grammar incorrectly many times, vocabulary. The expressions are very, very formal, many of them. So not very helpful in this situation. But there are some oldies that are good. And I use them all the time to teach both grammar and pronunciation and diction. If you watch TV, the same. Or if you like going to the movies a lot, well, there are some kinds of movies, some kinds of programs on TV that are going to be helpful, more helpful, and others than not, because they have more informal language, an informal tone. So for this particular part of the test, if this is what you want to focus on, try to avoid that. You will get a lot from that, but we are trying to focus on academic English. For example, I'm watching this TV sitcom on Netflix, That 70s Show. I learned a lot, tons, but they do use a lot of slang and I learn a lot from them, but their language is very colloquial and not very formal or academic. They insult each other a lot. And you end up copying that. I end up doing that at home when it is too much, because that's what we do as humans. We repeat. It's very funny. But if I want to improve academic English, I could watch something like Gilmore Girls, for example, which I also like very much. But there's a lot more talking, and the talking they do is a lot more formal. And you'll notice it right away. And then you'll find yourself using the phrases they use, using the kind of language they use, expressing in the way they express. I don't go to the movies much, but I'm thinking Avengers. So Avengers? I don't know. I'd say pretty formal, and there's not too much talking, too much action, probably. However, X-Men, when you got Dr. Xavier, and well, he's a scholar, and when he talks, he speaks in a very beautiful way, in a nice way, right? No? Okay. Which movie would you choose to learn more academic or formal speaking? I'll think of others too. Definitely The Lord of the Rings. But that's just because I'm a fan too. The Hobbit. Okay, you got the point? I hope you do. So try that. It's not going to be from today to tomorrow or a week from now. It'll take a little bit longer than that. But success stories are longer than a week, a month, and sometimes a year. So try this and let me know how it goes for you. Thank you very much for watching. Subscribe, please. Share. And I hope to see you soon.